and welcome to Life on Pig Row. This afternoon we're going to make a beautiful raspberry and cream sponge. Me and little Dee are going to make it together, aren't we, little Dee?
Yeah.
Yes. So here we have the ingredients that we need to make the sponge with. We have 6 ounces of plain flour.
We have 4 eggs.
We're going to use 3 of them. We have 1.5 tablespoons of baking powder. We have 6 ounces of sugar. And we have 6 ounces of butter. And we have some vanilla essence. I'm going to use about a tablespoon of that. This type of cake is known as an all-in-one sponge. And what the common thing is about all-in-one sponges is that they have the same amount of flour, sugar, butter and eggs. So they'll all weigh the same, they'll all weigh 6 ounces. First of all, little Dee is going to help me by oiling the cake tins. So we've got some butter here, just on a bit of the butter packet, and he's going to rub it all over the butter tin, aren't you, darling? Yeah. And this one as well. So all over like this, let me show you. We'll start it off for you. So you rub it all over like that. We'll put some more butter on here and then you can go back to rubbing it. So it's all over. We'll every bit oiled.
Every bit's gone.
Every bit off. So if you carry on doing that. Right. Now, basically, this cake's really easy because what you do is you bung it all into the bowl and mix it all up. So here we go. Flour and baking powder. The caster sugar. The butter, which I've grated to make it a bit soft. Now you don't have to do that, you can just wait until the butter's soft or soften the butter and use it like that, but it does need to be soft because otherwise it's going to be very hard to mix up. Now I've already weighed the eggs, but just to be sure, we'll weigh the eggs again.
We have made
roughly 6 ounces of eggs. That's usually about 3 large eggs.
Can you see the egg? Oh, very interesting eggs.
And there we have roughly six ounces of eggs. So we bung that in as well.
Bung it in?
Into the baking tin.
And then we mix.
And the last bit, oh, you're doing a good job there. You're going to finish that off for me?
Yeah.
And the last bit, we're going to put about, I've got these handy little implements, but you might have
which
a favourite spoon.
I'm
going to add about a tablespoon of vanilla extract. Now it's really important, it's the extract, not the essence, because it's got a more of a vanilla-y flavour. So I'm going to dump
that. Delicious!
Right, now it's a bit hard going at first, and what I find is if it doesn't mix properly, I like to start off with a wooden spoon and then finish off with a spatula. But if I find if it's not mixing properly, the best thing to do is to get a bowl of warm water sink and just plop the ball in there and it'll just warms the whole thing and just makes it easier to stir. I'm going to start mixing it together. So this is just basically mixing it all together, hence the name all-in-one sponge. Now this is the recipe that I use for my lemon drizzle cake as well, but when I'm making a lemon drizzle cake I add lemon peel. And sometimes I use lime peel as well, just to add a little bit something different. So this is quite thick and not that easy to stir, but it's starting to move. Have you finished doing those tins, darling? Oh, you've done such a good job with those. As you can see, they're oiled all over and ready for the cakes to go in there. Before I started the recipe, I put the oven on to start to preheat it, just so that when the mix is done, it'll be ready just to go straight into the oven. And I think I put that at, I'm not sure now, I think it's at gas mark 4, I think it's about 180. I'll confirm that at the end. Right, it's starting to move a little bit, but I think it needs a bit of that warmth. So I'm just going to go off now and warm the bowl a little and get that really moving.
I'm just beating this now in a bowl of warm, not hot water. It's important it's not hot. You don't want scrambled eggs. And as you can see, it's working a lot more. I'm using a spatula because I want to get lots and lots of lovely air in it to make it a nice light sponge.
Now here we've got a lovely light and airy sponge that I've just finished off, as you could see before. I'm going to divide it up and I'm going to tip it into the two cake tins, which little Dee so beautifully has done for me. But before I do that, what I need to do is this. I just add a little bit of flour to my butter cake tins, just a tiny little bit.
A little bit of red flour.
Which is the plain flour. And this is to stop the cake from sticking to the bottom of the tin. And I just shake it around like this. So it's all over the tin.
Can I stir the bowl for you?
You can carry on stirring that if you wish. Make sure you stir it clockwise.
Is this clockwise?
No, that's the other way. My grandma would say that's putting the devil in it if you were stir it anti-clockwise. But I think that's a bit of an old maid's tale. Just get rid of the excess.
We are cooked together.
Thank you. Right.
Try and taste a little
it's
bit.
It's quite heavy, this. I'm just going to...
Try and taste a little bit of it.
Get a bit in here.
And then turn it. What do you have to do after that? Do you have to flatten it?
Yes, I'm going to do that
in a minute. Can I do it?
You can help me. So we've got roughly half in each turn. And I'm just going to shake it until it's flat. Until it's flattened. Looks nice, doesn't it? Look. What are you doing?
Looking at it.
Cheeky chops. There we go. And these are ready to go in the oven. Now they're going to go in the oven for roughly 20-25 minutes. Mm. Quite often I cook it in a bigger cake tin, so I cook that for about 30 minutes. So this is going to be a little bit of trial and error.
I saw someone do it.
And it is at gas mark 4, which is 180 centigrade, in a fan oven. Is that nice? Hi, we're back again with the sponges. Little Dee's gone off to do his own thing now. And here they are. It took about 15 minutes in my oven, but my oven's very keen. And the way that you test them is to put a skewer in them, and if the skewer comes out clean, they're ready to go. As long as they look browned and everything, you'll get there with practice. Anyway, so we've got the two sponges, and now we're going to fill them with the lovely fillings that we've got here. We've got some homegrown raspberries, which have been grown in our garden, which look absolutely delicious. We've had a really good year for raspberries this year. We've got some beautiful strawberry and raspberry jam, again, out of our homegrown fruit. And we've got some lovely whipped cream. Right, so now we're going to put the sponge together. I like to do it on a cake stand. It just makes it easier. You can do it on a plate or whatever you like. So we take the sponge, and this is the top reel of the sponge, but the best thing to do is to place it down. Actually, check both your sponges to see which is the best top, because that will be the finale of your cake. So we put the sponge cake on the cake stand. We just take a bit of the jam. You want to mix up the jam to make sure it's nice and soft and you're not going to get a big lump. And just put it into the middle of the cake, like so. Don't be stingy with the jam. There's nothing worse than a mean, stingy sponge, but make sure you don't put too much on because you don't want it pouring out. And you need to make sure that your sponges are absolutely cooled before you do this. Cooled rather than cold, because otherwise your jam's going to run like mad. And your cream's going to run as well. You don't want that. So we're going to put all the jam all the way around the middle. Make sure you've got plenty near the edges. You want it to look nice when you put the sponge together. So I think, size that strawberry, we're just about there. Let's get a bit more around the edges. So there's your jam. That gives you a lovely flavour and something for these beautiful raspberries to stick to. So we're going to start off by just placing them like this. Make sure you've got plenty of fruit in there. this has worked out quite well. I just sort of estimated how many would need, but it's worked out quite well. And one for the chef. Mm. Right, cream time. Well, I like to do this with my spatula. As you can see, it's nicely thickened. It could actually be do with being a bit thicker, but thicker than that, really. Just going to dollop it over the top, like so. Again, making sure all that lovely cream. Oops, one's going for a walk there. Drips between. Oh, the yummy, yummy raspberries. You don't have to use all the cream. I've used about 3/4 of a tub of cream, a medium tub of cream. I'm not sure how much is in the tub. Let me have a look. 300 millilitres, so probably about 200 millilitres, and I've whipped it up with some vanilla extract, again, must be extract, and some sugar, but just a teaspoon, just so it tastes a bit more, I don't know what the word is, finished, I don't know. And there you go. I could just dive in with that before you even put the top on. Right, and there's your cream. And carefully, turning it over until it's pretty side, like I said before, plump the top down on the cake gently. Ta-da! There you go. Beautiful, delicious raspberry and cream sponge.